Hello, and welcome to another Fallout 76 episode. Today, we're returning to the Tyler County Fairgrounds in search of a missing boy, Freddy Wood. His missing poster is on the side of one of the outbuildings. And in the description, it tells us to go to Wavy Willard's Water Park and make contact with Miss Annie.
You there. You're here to find Freddy? His father. He put a tracker on Freddy that the lovely boy could not remove. But on that terrible day, it stopped. The policemen, they tried. It was simple. Clues were found here. Then, this. Hi, Freddy. He was not found. Such a clever boy. Now, maybe a man. Such a long time to wait for word of Mokichu.
But Nanny, she can do my best. The security office is on.
And so begins the quest, Cold Case. I'm bringing Nick Valentine along in spirit as we head over to the security office to check out the terminal.
Hey, where's your nanny? You know what? I have a surprise for you. I don't want the other kids to see, though. They might get jealous.
What is it? What's my surprise? I want to see it. Please. Please. Where is it?
I don't think your nanny will like it. Let's take off your ID there so she can't find you. And then I can take you to the surprise.
Oh, what's that sound, boys and girls?
Thank you.
Our search for Freddy Wood continues at the Clarksburg Post Office, where we have to search box number 12. The Clarksburg Post Office is south of the Wavy Willards Water Park, and the area is pretty infested with all kinds of super mutants and Mirelurks. But you can kind of sneak around into the post office if you're careful. Good luck. So now we have Otis Pike's address. He lives here in Grafton. So we're going to journey over to his house. Seriously, this would be my luck. Like, 5 Mirelurks. And that's me trying to launch, like, any kind of frag grenade or a Molotov cocktail, but I didn't have any engaged. So I thought I'd drop a couple mines, and then, gee, that's where Freddy decided to show up. Let's throw in a few Scorched, and I abandoned my teammate because I'm recording for this video. We have reached the home of Otis Pike. Now we can search for clues inside. First, there's a note on the floor. And then the terminal in the basement. Now we have arrived at Grafton Dam. If you look over to the right side of the building, you'll see two pipes sticking out of the side of the cement. The one on the right has an opening that you can easily drop down into and get into the basement of the dam. This place is infested with super mutants, so it may take you a little time to get through it, but you can. But sneaking in is the best way. Next, we find the body of Otis Pike.
Go ahead and hide, little bleeder.
So Freddy Wood decided to head home. He left Otis Pike behind to whatever happened to him, whether he jumped from here or whether he was killed by a super mutant, we'll never know. One last clue. When we search the sack on the ground, we find Arthur Wood's lighter. And the quest now takes us to the Woods estate, where hopefully we will find out what really happened to Freddy Wood. So Freddy Wood survived the initial bomb blast and was taken by a Vault-Tec rep to a Vault-Tec safe house or a vault close by this location. So it is quite possible that Freddy Wood is still inside the vault and will emerge at some point in the future. Now we have to journey to see Miss Annie and tell her what happened to Freddy Wood.
Thank you.
This writing, this is Freddy's. His father, he did not want Freddy with the uncle, but so much love Freddy had for him. Oh, mon petit chou, so terrible for my brave boy. This you found at the home? Oh, my poor child, such fear. The writing says he went to safety before the bombs. This means he could live. Thank you. These things I have found, you must take as a reward.
And as the quest completes, we are rewarded with a plan for a 10mm SMG and Perfect Storm, a very special 10mm SMG. And that concludes Cold Case. I hope you enjoyed the episode. Thanks for watching, and see you at the next one. Bye.